Creating and sending email campaigns by ERP Guru. In this tutorial video, we're going to take a look at how to create and send email blasts or email campaigns. While this is a six-step process, if you do it a couple of times, it'll become second nature. Step one, setting email domains. If you're going to be sending more than 10,000 emails per month, it is necessary to create a domain specific to sending emails. Once you've done this, you attach the email domain by going to Setup, Website, Domains, where you type in the name of the domain. You're going to select it hosted as email campaign. Choose live hosting files, and then select save. Step 2, setting up campaign email addresses. In order to send emails from NetSuite, you need to specify the send from and reply to email addresses. In order to start the setup process, choose Setup, Marketing, Email Addresses. You'll see a list here of previously set up email addresses. Select New and type in the email address you would like to set up. By clicking Save, an authorization email is sent to that email address. If we select an email address that's already been set up in the system, for example, this one for Erica, and choose Edit, you'll see the spot where the authorization code goes. The email that is sent to the person will have this code that you put in here. Once you do that, click Save, and the email address will be set up completely. By going to Marketing Preferences, you can specify the reply email address and the from email address here, as well as the campaign domain. You'll see the one that we created earlier. Click Save, and you're all set. Step 3, creating your saved search and group. In order to send out your email blast to its intended recipients, this is a two-step process. To begin with, you're going to create your saved search. In this case, we're going to create a saved search based on contacts. Name the saved search whatever it is you'd like. In this case, we're calling it North American Email Blast. We're going to make it public so that other people can view the saved search if necessary. Our main criteria for the saved search is going to be country. For North America, we're going to select the two main countries, Canada and the US. And click Save. The second step to the process is taking your saved search and associating it with a marketing group. Go to Lists, Relationship, Group, and create a new group. We're going to keep this group dynamic so that if the saved search updates in the future, the group will automatically update. We're going to choose Contact as our type of member and create a name for our group. This can be different from the name of your saved search. We're going to locate and select the saved search we previously created, and you'll notice that the group members populate down below, and click Save. Step 4, creating your email. This is the step in the process where you get to create your email copy that is going to be sent to your recipients. Navigate to Documents, Templates, Marketing Templates, and we're going to create a new one. In this case, we're choosing Campaign as the type and selecting a name for our email. This is not the subject line of the email, rather a name for internal purposes. We're going to choose Text Editor. And within this, you have the basic editing functions such as bolding, italics, and underlining. There are also some other features such as restricting access and the Marketing tab, where you'll be able to determine who the from address and the reply to addresses are from. Make sure that you check the Track Outgoing Email option, as this is going to allow for the statistics to be gathered. Step 5, putting it all together. This is where we take all the information or tasks previously completed and bring them together in order to send out your email blast. Navigate to your marketing campaigns. We're going to create a new one for this email blast. Choose a title for your marketing campaign. The category is the type of campaign. Start date if you wish it to be today or potentially in the future. The next part is very important. You're going to select your target group, or the group that we previously created, the template, which we just made, and because the template didn't actually have a subject written in it, you can choose a title for your email blast here. If a subject was already created within the template, this will auto-populate. This is obviously an email. You're going to choose a status to execute and confirm the time. Remember that NetSuite sends out email blasts on the hour. If you're saving your email campaign at 1:15, the next available time will be 2 p.m. Step 6, follow up and statistics. Once your email blast is sent and it's had a couple of hours to gather statistics, you can navigate back to the marketing campaigns. Locate the campaign you're wishing to look at, in this case our ABC Pharma Email Blast 1, and go to the Statistics tab. This is where you'll find important information about the date that it was executed, the number of sent, number of opened, and the percentages. You'll also see click-throughs and a click-through percentage, the number of responded and the percentage of those who responded, any people who unsubscribed, or bounced.